Hello, my name is Larry Fleming, and I'm doing this video today to talk a little bit about securing our democratic process and keeping a proper election in the future. I'm not saying that we had fraud in the election this year by any means. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is that there's been an appearance of fraud, or at least the appearance of the vulnerability of fraud. So we should really try to eliminate these appearances, eliminate the risk, and to protect our democratic system. My biggest complaint this year was what happened when I voted. I received this ballot in the mail, and instead of returning it in the mail, I went down to the polling location and actually voted in person. And now I regret it. And here's why. After I filled out the questions on the voting machine, it printed a ballot for me, which I then dropped in the box and trusted that my ballot, my vote would be counted properly. Problem is, that ballot that I dropped in the box that it printed for me was nothing more than a QR code that supposedly had retained the proper information. But when I looked at it, I couldn't tell what information was on there. And I couldn't even tell if I was kept anonymous or not. Now, I don't really care about the anonymity, but some people do, and it is part of our democratic process. So some people want to guarantee anonymity, but yet still be able to track and view their ballots. Now, the biggest problem with that QR code is that during the actual vote count, the inspectors, the third party people that are watching to view the fair process, they can't look at a QR code and see that it's being properly tabulated. They're just trusting the very same machine that the people scanning the ballots and are using. Nobody can really verify that it's being properly representing what I put into that machine. Nobody can verify that. In fact, it's completely eliminated the ability for a hand count later. You could take all those ballots and put them in boxes. Nobody, not one person on this planet, not a million people on this planet getting together can look at those QR codes and hand count them. It's impossible. They've removed the securities of the democratic system. So I want to talk about how we can bring it back and actually make it more secure than ever. So my suggestion is this: when you receive a ballot in the future, there would be a portion on the top or the bottom of the ballot that you tear off and you retain. And that piece you tear off and retain would have two pieces of information on it. It would have your name and have your voting number. Your voting number would also be on the ballot. When you turn in your ballot, nobody's gonna know that that's your ballot except for you, because you have the little stub from the bottom that says that that's your ballot. Now, after you turn in that ballot, you'll be able to go to a website, some government website. Who knows what it'll be? Fairvotes.gov, whatever. Government website. You'll be able to click on your state, and then the county, and then the district. And that's going to bring you to the next page. And that page is going to tell you how many registered voters there are in that county. And those registered voters will basically be tracked by address and name. So somebody can verify, and I can verify, that these people really exist because the address is real. 123 Any Street. Somebody can go there to that address and verify that that's me, and that I'm voting, and that that's my residence. Now, you can't just make up fake addresses, put down abandoned houses, because somebody will see, hey, there isn't a house there, or that house was burned down 4 years ago. Or you can go to that house and find out that there's only two people that live there, but there's like seven people registered, and then you're gonna be able to identify the fraud. Now, let's say you don't wanna put your name out there on your address, you wanna stay anonymous, that's fine, you can still do it. You're listed as anonymous, but somebody can still go to 162 Elm Street and verify that there is one person there, or two, or three, or however many people are listed with that address, because it doesn't matter the name, it matters how many people are there. Now you've done something to ensure that you have the proper number of voters in that district, and it's a real number because these are real addresses. Now, you know that number. Now you come to another page. This page is going to tell you how many people actually voted. And there's going to be a list of numbers starting at 001 all the way up until the final number that's going to be the same as that number. This number on the very bottom of the very last page is going to match that number. Not that number. Why? Because some people aren't going to vote. They won't return their ballot. And a few numbers you click on might bring you to an X, means there's no ballot that was turned in for that number. This gives the person that owns that number the opportunity to recognize their ballot wasn't received. And they have up until the election day to fix that. If everybody does that, this number will eventually equal this number. Now, let's just say that my piece of paper that I retained says my number is 215,182. I can go there, I can click on that, and I can view my actual ballot, or at least the selections I placed on my ballot. I can see that I might have voted blue for president and Republican for representative, and I might have voted yes for Prop 12 and no for Prop 87, but I can see that my information is properly recorded. I can see every single other ballot in my district. Every single one, I can see it. I can view every single one. Or even outside of my district, I could go to a different county and I can view all of their ballots. But I cannot link a single ballot to a single person except mine, because I have my number. This gives every single person the ability to download this into an Excel spreadsheet. Every single person can download this, and every single person in the whole world can actually go and be part of a manual hand count. Every single person can say, hey, this is real. This number of people voted for this in this district. It removes the doubt, but keeps the anonymity, ensures your ballot counts. If it's not there, you can fix it. If it's wrong, you can fix it. So I encourage that we all encourage our government to move to a system like this to protect the democratic system, instead of moving to a blind system of QR codes that puts the power of the election into the people writing software, because that's wrong. Whether they cheated or not doesn't matter. The problem is that it creates doubt. And when you create doubt, you create chaos, you create conspiracy theories, and you also open the door for fraud. We need to close the door on fraud, we need to close the door on doubt, and we need to open the door on a fair democratic process that we all have confidence in. So we got 4 years to fix it for the next election. Let's demand that our government fixes it and stop with this hammer stuff. Stop with the scorecard bullshit. Keep it open, keep it fair, keep it viewable for everybody. Maintain the original ballots. Don't transfer them into a QR code that we cannot see. Thanks for watching. Please share this video. And also, if you don't want to share the video, share the idea. Talk to everybody about this basic concept. This is easy to do. In today's technology, this is very simple. We could have been doing this 20 or 30 years ago. As soon as the internet was invented, this could have been done. This is old technology. Let's get this done. Let's make this happen, and let's have a fair America in which we all can agree, and we'll stop the efforts in recounts. We will know the day after the election. Everybody will know with confidence. And we won't have to have all these petitions and file stuff in courts and eliminate it all. Make it fair. Make it simple. Thanks for watching. Like I said, please share the video, and at the very least, share the idea. Thanks again.